So from this paper, question number 4, first one is from progressions, geometric progression. The first term of GP is 27 and 8th term is 1 by 81. These two are given conditions. Find the sum of first 10 terms you need to find out. Now let us see this, find out how to find out. Let us see. Let me take the given data first. So here given the first term, so A is equals to 27 and let R be the common ratio. Then 8th term is given, so A8 is 1 by 81. Based on this, 2 will find out the sum of first 10 terms. First 10 terms you need to find out. A8 is 1 by 81, but A8 formula A into R to the power 7. Okay. That is equals to 1 by 81 from this. A is 27 into R to the power 7 is equals to 1 by 81. Then R to the power 7 is equals to 1 by 81 into 1 by 27. So this is 1 by 3 to the power 7. 3 power 7 is 81 into 27. 81 is a 3 power 4. 27 is 3 power 3. So R power 7 is 1 by 3 power 7. Then R is equals to 1 by 3. Because you can write 1 by 3 all to the power 7. Okay? R is equals to 1 by 3. Now this is less than 1. If R value is less than 1, we need to write the SN formula. Sum of n terms. Sum of n terms is A into 1 minus R power n by 1 minus R. Okay, this is when R value is less than 1. So according to problem, we need to find out sum of 10 terms. S10 is equals to A into. So A is 27, 1 minus R power 10. So R is 1 by 3, 1 by 3 to the power 10 by 1 minus 1 by 3. So let us simplify this. Sum of 10 terms will get 27 into 1 minus 1 by 3 power 10. So that is 1 minus 1 by 3 to the power 10 by 1 minus 1 by 3 is 2 by 3. 2 divided by 3. Again simplify. 27 into 2 by 3 is take reciprocal 3 by 2. Right. Into 1 minus 1 by 3 to the power 10. That's it. You can simplify more. 27, 3 is 81. So 81 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by 3 to the power 10. Okay, don't multiply 3 10 times, take long time. So is this enough? This is the solution. Sum of 10 terms. Now, second is from trigonometry. Prove that sin theta by sec plus tan minus 1 plus cos theta by cosec theta plus cot theta minus 1 is equals to 1. Let us take the LHS and then prove this RHS 1. So left hand side that given is sin theta by trigonometric formulas you must know perfectly. Then only can solve it easily. Sec theta plus tan theta minus 1 plus cos theta by cosec theta plus cot theta minus 1. Let us simplify this. Take all tan terms to sin by cos, sec terms is 1 by cos, you can convert. Everything converted to sin and cos. Then you can take the common easily. Sin theta by sec is 1 by cos formula. Plus tan theta is sin theta by cos theta minus 1. Plus cos theta is numerator. Cosec is 1 by sin theta. Cot theta is cos theta by sin theta minus 1. Let us take the LCM in denominator place, then simplify easily. That is sin theta by cos theta is LCM. That is 1 plus sin theta minus cos theta. plus here also same cos theta is numerator and sin theta is LCM for denominator, that is 1 plus cos theta minus sin theta, right? Then take this denominator fraction to reciprocal, then that becomes sin theta cos theta, sin theta into cos theta by, again this is 1 plus sin minus cos, 1 plus sin theta minus cos theta, it also same cos theta, denominator is sin theta, by again 1 plus cos theta minus sin theta. Let us take sin into cos is common from the numerator both, sin theta into cos theta, let us take common, everything is common means 1 by 1 minus sin minus cos plus 1 by 1 plus cos minus sin theta. Just to take the LCM in this bracket, some get cancellations. So sin theta into cos theta. Here is first numerator into next fraction denominator. So finally we'll get 1 plus cos theta minus sin theta plus again 1 minus sin theta minus cos theta. Fraction denominator. Cross multiplication. Again both the denominators we multiply. That is 1 plus common. Then sin theta minus cos theta. Similarly from this, okay, previous step, 1 plus this is 1 plus sin minus cos, 1 plus cos minus sin. Okay. And plus into 1 minus you take common. Then sin theta minus cos theta you get. Because denominator can apply a plus b into a minus b formula. For that you should take this. And there will be some cancellations here, you can do cancel. Minus cos theta plus cos theta get cancelled. And minus sin. Plus sin, because this is a plus and this also should be plus only. LCM we took separately. Then finally we'll get sin theta cos theta. Here only 1 plus 1 is 2 is left. Next down is a plus b into a minus b. So 1 square minus this both. That is sin theta minus cos theta square. Apply a plus a minus b also from the denominator for both here. That is sin theta into cos theta 2 by 1 minus. Apply a minus b whole square formula. That is sin square theta a minus b whole square. A plus a square plus b square, right? Minus 2ab. Then cos square theta minus 2 sin theta cos theta. We know sin square plus cos square is 1. This value is 1. And finally, sin theta into cos theta. Here 2 by 1 minus, this is completely 1. 1 minus 2 sin theta cos theta. And here minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled. Minus 1 plus 1. And minus to minus, next up is plus. Therefore, sin theta cos theta into 2 by minus to minus plus 2. Sin theta cos theta. So this is 2 to cancel and sin into cos, sin into cos. So finally that is equal to 1. That is the RHS. Okay. Just step wise you should take one by one. Only it looks big steps, but little practicing you to do using the same formulas. If you take LHS and apply any concept, any trigonometric formulas, finally you should prove the RHS. Right. And next question is using graph paper for this question. Let us solve, take the graph paper. Okay, so here question is, use the graph paper for this question. A point A is reflected to A dash in the x axis. The coordinates of its image is 2, minus 3. So A dash is given 2 comma minus 3, a we should find out first. So let me take the graph paper. So in this x coordinates, x and y axis, center is this x axis and y axis you take both axes. According to the problem here, let a be a comma b and a dash is given, that is 2 comma minus 3, because reflection, we know that a is reflection, there is reflection on x-axis. So whenever reflection on x-axis means a dash becomes a comma minus b, only y coordinates will be changed. Then therefore from this a is equals to 2 comma 3, because 3 sign only should be changed, because a reflection is a dash, if it is 2 comma 3, this is 2 comma minus 3. So a is a 2 comma 3. Now we will solve the problems according to given. So this is a 2 comma 3. Coordinates of a double dash is a under reflection in the y axis. A double dash is a under reflection in the y axis. So let us keep the points first. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on. This is the x axis and vertically is y. So positive is 1, 2, 3, 4. And negative side is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on. Minus 1, minus 2. Down is negatives. We need to point first a is 2, 3. So 2, 3 is this. This is a. And a dash is 2 comma minus 3. So this is the a dash 2 comma minus 3. Right? Now a double dash is reflection on y axis. Next, if you solve the problem, this is the first one. And second one is a is 2 comma 3, but they said reflection in y axis. When it's reflection in y axis, x coordinate sign will be changed, that is a double dash. So minus 2 comma 3, right? Because a dash is line parallel to y axis, distance of 2 units. Then a double dash is minus 2 comma 3. Just you can keep minus 2 comma 3 is this side. So a double dash is minus 2 comma 3. And the coordinates of the image b dash is of the point b 1 comma 2 in the line a dash. So line a dash. So a dash is line is this. Because from y axis is 2 points. Then 2 points far away. Then you can write the third one. B is 1 comma 2. Reflection in x is equals to 2. This is parallel to y axis at 2 points, that is b dash. So 3 comma 2, because x value is 1 plus 2 is 3, so b dash is 3 comma 2, this third one. Then we need to plot this b dash also. So b dash, so b is 1 comma 2, b is given 1 comma 2 and b dash is 3 comma 2. B dash is 3 comma 2 and b is 1 comma 2. Now they are asking name the triangle a dash b dash and b. Okay, a dash b dash only b. A dash is here, b dash here is b is this. Just if you join these lines, what shape we get? This exactly centered to the b dash. That means a dash b and a dash b dash sides are same. If you observe, these two sides are equal. This is different, 2 units. Then when two sides are equal, one side is not equal to other two sides, means it is isosceles triangle. Therefore triangle a dash b dash b is an isosceles triangle, because two sides are equal. Out of 3, 2 are equal and third one is non equal to this. Then this is the isosceles triangle, right? Just if you draw the diagram clearly, we can solve the problem simply. And let us see, this is about fourth one. Let's see question number 5 and solve these problems in section B.